Welcome back. The winner in this year's video art category is also our Best of Show winner. In fact, Nathan Gotch from Fort Wayne Concordia Lutheran High School not only won the video category, he pulled off the Project Excel hat trick, becoming the first contestant in the 12-year history of the competition to place first, second, and third within a given category. That's an accomplishment that deserves a closer look.
That's right. We're starting her out on three. We're going to turn her to one. Do you know what's up with their mics, Ryan, or is it just the same problems we always have? All right, go ahead and go back in the booth, John.
All right.
You're here today. Let's start out on three.
Okay, and some tips on this.
We'll come back on one. Yeah, get something cool, Jeff. I don't really care. How about Jeff? We want to put that, like, right. Yeah, put it on. All right, settle down, kids.
Video voice is our show.
Okay, ready? Move now and go to him.
Hello, and welcome to Video Voice News. I'm Andy Ellis.
It's kind of a variety show. We have two hosts that run through the show. There's a news segment, a sports segment, and all different kinds of stuff.
Yeah, pull out one as far as you can, and two, why don't you pull out all the way, too?
It's been really good some weeks. It's been really lame some weeks.
We're here live at Concordia High School Student Lab.
Too bad we didn't do more of these. This looks good. Hey, be quiet for a second, Chelsea.
Hey, Nathan.
Yeah.
For the opening, are we going to do that?
Most kids, when they're growing up, they're watching a lot of TV, and they always, you know, you're always kind of enamored with the whole situation of, you know, who's in the box and all that kind of stuff. And then you go from a point, I think, where you enjoy watching TV, and then for me it was to where, you know, I wanted to make that kind of stuff happen and be able to produce some of the things that I was seeing.
I think in every teacher's career, you look for that student that really goes as far as you can take them, and Nathan's that student.
I'd like to do another one of those slide overs if Justin wants to try it again, just because I think it can look really cool.
The media arts advisor here pushes Project Excel really hard. We've had a lot of state finalists in the years past.
Let's go to something that no one does want to miss. That's sports with Tim Winston.
I just got an idea. You know, why don't we make a parody of presidential commercials? And I couldn't think of a better guy to have run for president than John Feskin. He's probably the least presidential person you'll ever meet in your life.
Our nation's schools are struggling, but John Feskin has a plan to improve education.
I have a plan to improve education.
In the last 30 years, America's test scores have drastically decreased. John Feskin has a plan to improve those test scores.
My plan is to give students the answers. We've tried this in my home state, and test scores have risen. It's a proven plan, and it works.
John Feskin, for president. Innovative ideas that work.
The thing you notice about John first is the way that he looks. And then you pick up his mannerisms too. It's kind of the whole John Feskin's package. It's an entertaining guy, fun guy to be around.
While John Feskin's has been busy campaigning on the issues, his opponents have been airing negative ads. Feskin's is a joke, says Vice President Al Gore. Who is this guy, wonders Governor George W. Bush. But it's time to stop avoiding the facts. Bush and Gore have been copying off John Feskin's. John Feskin's is the reformer with the results. He's the uniter, not the divider, and he will fight for families. George W. Bush and Al Gore, stop lying. Now. John Feskin's. For president.
At first we were just trying to go for something that would be funny, make people laugh, but I think, you know, if you look at a deeper level, you know, you see the way that the politicians use advertising in the media to try to influence the voters. One of John's friends, her mom actually voted for John. She wrote him in after seeing his political commercials on Video Voice.
Last Tuesday, John Feskin's got one vote. He lost. Badly. But is he asking for a recount?
It's one vote. You can count it as many times as you want. It's still one.
John Feskin's wants to follow the will of the people, and the people only gave him one vote.
I think it's important for a president to have mastered basic math skills like addition.
John Feskin's for president, because he's not a sore loser.
I was doing some research on a project in one of my English classes. It was about Ernest Hemingway, and I was just reading in one of the books about his suicide and the fact that he shot himself with a rifle from Abercrombie & Fitch. Of course, you wouldn't connect that event with the brand name Abercrombie & Fitch today. So that kind of caught my eye, and then I was in the mall, I think later on that week, with one of my buddies, and we walked by the Abercrombie & Fitch store, and I said, hey, let me tell you a story about this, and he said, well, you know, why don't we make a t-shirt with that on it? And I said, hey, I got a better idea. Why don't we make a commercial about it?
Yeah. I like it when the girls stop by. In the summer. Do you remember? Do you remember when we met that summer? New kids on the block had a bunch of hits. Chinese food makes me sick, and I think it's fly when girls stop by for the summer. For the summer. I like girls that wear Abercrombie and Fitch. I'd take her if I had one wish. But she's been gone since that summer. Since that summer. Hip-hop mama, they speak in span. Met you one summer and it all began. You're the best girl that I ever did see. The great Larry Bird jersey, 33. When you take a sip, you buzz like a hornet. Billy Shakespeare wrote a whole bunch of sonnets. Call me with...
In the middle of December, just something hit me where one of my really good friends just found out that he had a brain tumor that was inoperable, incurable.
The doctor in Fort Wayne, he got to the point, which was good. He said that I'm in either a stage one or a stage two of my tumor. A stage one, 40% of the people make it 10 years. And a stage two, 40% of the people make it 5 years.
For me to be able to kind of share his story, his perspective with people that wouldn't have be able to have his perspective, be able to see, you know, his situations through the eyes of a 19-year-old kid who thought he had the rest of his life ahead of him, and then he's got a doctor telling him he's got 5 years to live.
Hearing that news was unbelievable. I it's almost like, you know, this can't be me. When he told me, I'm sitting there, and it was almost like a dream. It's just like, okay, you're telling me this, and I'm accepting it, but it's not me, so it doesn't make any difference. But then as time goes on, you start to realize that it is you, and you have to focus on how you're going to deal with it.
So kind of I wanted to show the emotions that came across and just the way that this whole, you know, the news, the tumor, everything coming so suddenly, the way that it influenced his life.
A lot's changed within these past several days, and how I adapted these changes will say a lot about who I am as a person, and hopefully I'll be the type of person that'll be able to handle this situation and maybe even use it to make an impression on other people.
And obviously, you know, the tumor, the news,
maybe the impression
that had a big influence on him, and I think that I was able to kind of communicate that with the audience through the piece that I did on Ken. You're trying to communicate something, a thought, a feeling that you have. You want to make other people feel how you feel, or you want to make them feel how you want them to feel. And so I think that's probably my primary goal as far as the stuff that I do in the media arts.
Great job, Nathan, and good luck with your film career. Stay tuned, I'll be right back with our final thoughts on this year's show.